वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह। यू आर वॉचिंग सिख टीवी। आई एम सरबजीत कौर। लेट्स बिगिन द बुलेटिन विद द टॉप हेडलाइंस। एम्प्लॉइज ऑफ बठिंडा थर्मल प्लांट शॉट ब्लैक फ्लैग्स टू मनप्रीत सिंह बादल। रिलेटिव्स ऑफ विक्की गौंडर अलेज्ड पुलिस फॉर फेक एनकाउंटर। पंजाब पुलिस नैब्ड 533 गैंगस्टर्स फ्रॉम पंजाब इन लास्ट ईयर। श्रोमणी अकाली दल स्लैम्स कांग्रेस फॉर शटिंग डाउन 1647 सेवा केंद्रस। इंडियन अथॉरिटीज रैटल्ड बाय लंदन कश्मीरी एंड सिख प्रोटेस्टर्स। फाउंडिंग फादर ऑफ पंजाब्स ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन डॉक्टर गुरचरण सिंह कालकर पास्ड अवे इन चंडीगढ़। जगमीत सिंह ब्रार अनाउंस्ड हिज रेजिग्नेशन एज पंजाब तृणमूल कांग्रेस चीफ। एम्बुलेंस बॉम्ब किल्ड 95 पर्संस इन काबुल। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द न्यूज। Members of Guru Nanak Dev Thermal Plant Employees Union showed black flags to Finance Minister Manpreet Singh Badal when he was returning after inaugurating a private education center in Bathinda. They were protesting against the state government's decision to shut down the Bathinda thermal plant. Anticipating that the situation might go out of control, a large number of police personnel were deployed at the venue. Gursevak Singh, one of the members of the union, said that the union will continue to protest till the government agrees to make the Bathinda thermal plant functional again. Harjinder Singh Puller, alias Vicky Gonda, a well-known discus throw player who later turned to be a wanted culprit, was shot dead by Punjab police. But Vicky Gonda's family at Srama Bodla village alleged that the encounter of Vicky Gonda was fake, as the police had already arrested Gonda and his aides on Thursday. Gonda's uncle Gurdev Singh and Harjit Singh claimed that it was not an encounter. The cops had nabbed Gonda and others a day in advance but killed them the next day. Punjab police has nabbed 533 gangsters and their accomplices in Punjab in last 1 year only. The police have recovered ₹1,07,189 vehicles and 97 weapons from their possession. The development has stressed the need to deal with the menace with an iron hand. DGP Suresh Arora demanded for enacting the controversial Punjab Control of Organized Crime Act. Talking about the achievement, DGP Intelligence Dinkar Gupta said that 21 gangsters who were listed in top two categories based on their criminal record had been nabbed in last 9 months. Punjab police said that they will nab all the remaining gangsters soon. On Saturday, Shromani Akali Dal started protest against Punjab Congress on the decision of shutting down Seva Kendras. In a statement, Shromani Akali Dal spokesman Daljit Singh Chima said that the Seva Kendras were constructed at a cost of ₹200 crore and equipped with modern technology. Instead of taking this reformatory step forward, the Congress wants to go back and utilize this modern infrastructure to house facilities which are already available to the people. Two groups of protesters clashed outside the Indian High Commission in London as Kashmiris and Sikhs jointly protested against the actions of Indian government. Sikhs and Kashmiris traditionally demonstrate on India's Republic Day outside the Indian High Commission in London to declare their desire for freedom from Indian occupation. However, it was the first time that Indian officials organized a counter-protest which turned violent as pro-Indian protesters attacked Sikhs and Kashmiris. Scotland Yard officials had to call for backup as they tried to separate the protesters. Well, this is all what we have in this edition. Stay tuned for more updates. And again, let's have a look on news headlines. Employees of Bathinda thermal plant showed black flags to Manpreet Singh Badal. Relatives of Vicky Gonder alleged police for fake encounter. Punjab police nabbed 533 gangsters from Punjab in last year. Shromani Akali Dal slams Congress for shutting down 1647 Seva Kendras. Indian authorities rattled by London Kashmiri and Sikh protesters. Founding father of Punjab's Green Revolution, Dr. Gurcharan Singh Kalkar, passed away in Chandigarh. Jagmeet Singh Brar announced his resignation as Punjab's Trinmool Congress chief. Ambulance bomb killed 95 persons in Kabul.